welcome back at this back at the back part. I've marked out, I've cut out the fabric for my back part. Here I marked out 1 inch for my starting point, and here this is my half length and my seam allowance. I also have 1.5 inch for my zip line. My zip will come here. I marked out 1.5 inch for it. As a beginner, if you cannot manage 1.5, you can use 1.75 or 2. So, and my fabric, I folded it into 2 as usual. So the next thing I'll do here is to take my nipple to nipple measurement. This time around, I'm not folding my nipple to nipple like this. Rather, I'll take a normal nipple to nipple measurement. My nipple to nipple, I'm working with 8 divided by 2, 4 plus half, 4 and half. I'll mark out that 4 and half all the way down. Mark 4 and half all the way down. But remember, like I told you earlier in my previous video, I told you that nipple to nipple, the darts at the back of your fabric starts 1 inch below your nipple, 1 inch below your chest line. The back dart starts 1 inch below your chest line, and the front dart starts 1 inch below your bust point. So it is on this nipple to nipple line that I'll make my dart. Therefore, I'll take my chest line measurement, and I'm working with a chest line of 8.5. I'll mark out 8.5 here. I'll mark out the 8.5 and I'll rule it out. Which means my nipple to nipple is going to start from this line down. I'll roll out my line. This is my nipple to nipple line, like this. Hope you can see it. Now let me repeat what I marked here. This is my starting point. This is my chest line. Chest line. This is my half length or waist measurement, and this is seam allowance. Then this is my starting point, and now my nipple to nipple line sits here, and then this is my zip area. This line here is my zip area. So I'll need to take my dart. The dart is marked on my half length, half inch on both sides. So I'll mark half here, mark half here. From here to here is half, from here to here is half. And like I said before, our back dart starts 1 inch below the chest line. This is chest line. 1 inch below it, you get your back dart. So I'll now connect from this point I marked to this one. I'll connect it like this. I'll also connect this one. Okay. So this is my dart. Next thing I'll do now is to take my shoulder measurement. I'm working with a shoulder of 16. In this case, I'm not adding 1.5 inches like I did at the front. I'll add my normal shoulder seam allowance, which is half inch. So my shoulder is 16 divided by 2, 8 plus half, 8 and half. This is my half here. So I can equally measure. Remember, any measurement you're taking from the zip line, don't bring it inside the zip area. So from here to, I'll mark out the same 8.5 so that I can get a straight line. So I'll mark it now. This becomes my armhole length. I'll construct this armhole. The back armhole is different from the front armhole. So for back armhole, there's no, you don't need much, just construct it as every normal armhole like this. See it here. So this is my back armhole. Just construct for my back armhole. And also, at this back area, I'm free to mark my neck because I'm not padding it. So I want to use a neck of 3.5 inches. That is my neck width, 3.5. And then my neck depth, I want to use a neck depth of 6 inches. She wants it to come down very well. So we use 6. Then I'll connect the line. The next thing also is to curve my back neck, curve it out. Curve out my back neck like this. Okay. And I need to take my shoulder slant. From here, I'll mark 1/2 inch. You can use 1. I keep saying you can use 1 for your shoulder slant. Well, I prefer using 1/2 for you. I'll mark my shoulder slant. Another thing I need to do now is to take the side measurement, the measurement on this side. So on this chest line, I'll take my bust measurement. My bust is 37 divided by 4. 37 divided by 4. On this half length, I'll mark my bust measurement. On this chest line, sorry, I'll mark my bust measurement. Now, my bust is 37 divided by 4, 9.25 plus 3. I'm using 3 inches. I told you at this area, take note, I'm using 3 inches. So I'll get 12.25. This is my 12.25 here. 12.25. And then on my half length, I'll take my waist measurement. My waist is 32.5 divided by 4 plus 3. I have 11.25. Now remember, I have my dart here. Take note of this dart. 1 inch for my dad, take note of it. So that's 11.25. I'll add 1 inch to it to get 12.125. So this is 12.125 somewhere here. Now I'll connect the line like so. Okay, connect it from this area. So I don't think there's anything left with this. We are okay with a back blouse. So I'll start cutting. First of all, I'll notch my dart area. Don't forget to do that. As well as my zip area. Notch it. I've notched my dart. I've notched my zip. Then I'll start cutting off from here. Then I'll cut here. Let my shoulders slant. The neck. Pass it off like that. So I'll notch this area as well, the zip area on my neck side. I'll notch it. Okay. So what is left? You're okay with this. So it is that you hold it like this, so it's down. This is all for a back blouse. And of course, you have to open up the zip. Open it up like this. And then, this is what we've got for the back part. Okay, as you follow us along, you experience how we cut the part for the front blouse. This is my front blouse here. So you follow us in our next video, you see how we are going to cut part for this blouse. Not just cutting it, we'll cut the part. We'll sew it, yes, and the part, we'll sew it, yes, and then we'll cut the lower part for the gown, because we are sewing a penciled padded or penciled bustier gown. Thank you. Okay, if this video has been helpful, please like, share, and subscribe our page. Then click on the notification bell so that whenever we make new posts, you always get it immediately. And then if you need to know more from where this is coming from, join us in our fashion school, Gifted Hands Fashion House, Anambra State in Nnewi.